In this video, we consider the third scheme of lighting. It's late evening or night. The first thing we have to understand is that the photographer always takes such picture with a shutter speed and absolutely dark sky or dark blue sky will be lighter with shutter speed, of course. Therefore, those light fittings that are inside the building, inside the interior, inside the space, will be overexposed. So again, we're exhibited in the outer space, and the overexposure will be inside, and there will be high-intensity light sources. The darker is the outside, the brighter the flare will be. What light sources we have here? They're quite simple. They simulate the ceiling light sources. This is the first group. The second internal block also consists of ceiling lights. This is just corona light in the form of a sphere. And the same here, in the third row. Here, I just put a plan. Corona light that gives light from the building. In this way, we simulate the participation of light in the courtyard lighting. This occurs with shutter speed. The second light source here is directed the different way, creating such long shadows that ostensibly radiate from inside the building, from inside the space. The bigger the value of shutter speed, the brighter it is. Thus, there is more light. The light passes to our camera longer. And then such details appear, which you wouldn't have seen in the ordinary photographing. So you need to remember three rules. First, the sky will be brighter than it is. Second, our inside space will be overexposed. And third, if we use shutter speed, the flares will become brighter and detailed shadows appears that you wouldn't have seen in the ordinary photographing. Illuminate trees and shrubs. This is also done in landscape design. There are ceiling light sources set here. They are invisible, so we don't need models. We just use corona light here. In this case, it's a disc shape. Also, we can illuminate all the trees. I decided to illuminate only the left part here. You can additionally install the external sources of light just to light up the path. I put only three here, for example. Since we have a very big flare, as it should be with shutter speed, we see a big flare, and it consequently covers the model that we could apply. So in this case, I just applied corona light in the form of a disc, in the form of a cylinder actually. Thereby, these light sources are warmer. I set value of 2000. It's quite powerful. These sources of light are slightly colder, but also warm enough. That's it. I also applied a standard mat, our material, with such values to the volumetric. We already know how to vary these values. The greater the value, the lower is the density of our fog. In this case, it's not a fog, it's not a haze, but an overexposure from our light sources. And as for HDRI, we have one HDRI without any additional light sources for the field light. In this case, I found the right position so that this light spot from the setting sun is behind the camera. Still, some part of it hit the line of sight. Therefore, in height, I lowered this value here, and here we have this part of the setting sun. It can be seen a little bit. It's barely visible here, but this is normal. It can be so, and it looks right and physically correct. Then about exposure, I set the approximate value. Highlight compressed to maximum. I lowered the white balance to make the picture colder, because the night render, nighttime or late evening, should have a colder shade. I didn't change the contrast. I raised filmic highlights almost to maximum to reduce overexposure from light sources a little bit. In this case, it is appropriate. Filmic shadows gave us missing contrast. We could also add vignette in this case, which would be right. Let's move on. LUT is standard here. It adds a little of warmth to the picture. I set bloom to practically the lowest value. Glare intensity I set to 1. And I lowered color shift a bit to make our flares a little warmer. I increased here, I guess its default value is 3. So I increased this rays quantitatively and turned it to minus 90 degrees. In the same way, I empirically found the right turn. Then I slightly blur it, and there is a sharpen. You can see all the settings. Again, don't forget that they are selected individually for each render. But the most important rules that you must remember, I will repeat them. The bright sky, the overexposure inside, and intensive flares with additional detailed shadows, which wouldn't exist if we not shot with shutter speed. The application of shutter speed is justified by the fact that we need to get a brighter picture. That's why here we have a little different rules, a little different light than if we had took picture, had made a render in the daytime, in the morning or evening lighting. I also added corona color correction, as always, and by lowering gamma practically in half and increasing exposure, I got a cold color, violet in this case, and more contrast sky. And even if the trees are not lighted by some light sources embedded in the ground, point lights, photographers often resort to additional flares pointed towards the trees, then illuminate the trees in post-production, thus imitating point lights embedded in the ground. This adds extra volume to the scene, trees, and improves the picture. For example, here in a medium shot, we could eliminate this bush, this small tree, so that the volume appears. Now it looks like it doesn't belong here, but again, we're still experimenting. In general, these basic rules will help you to set up your night or late evening render properly.